What's up, guys? In this short tutorial, I will show you how to run a background check on a user on your Discord server. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. To run a background check on a user, we will make use of the Dino Discord bot. To add Dino to your server, simply head over to dino.gg and make sure to log in with your Discord account. You can then authorize the bot to make changes on your server. Next, select Manage Servers, and you will then see a list of servers you have joined. Simply select the one you are managing and where you have admin permissions. Under Modules, make sure to enable the Custom Commands module and then navigate to its settings. Here, select to add a new command. Name this command to something easy you can remember, such as BC for background check. Next, paste this command from the description below. You can also find it in my more extensive guide linked in the description below. In your custom command options, you have the option for the bot to automatically delete your command after writing it. You can also send the bot response as a direct message to the user who wrote the command. Under Permissions, set the Allowed and Ignored role for the bot, which means roles will be allowed to run a background check and which roles are not allowed to. The same goes for text channels below. The Response channel is a selected text channel where Dino will display the background check information. This should not be a too public channel. Your advanced options let you create a command cooldown, after which you can use the command again for another user. The delete after command will trigger the bot to automatically delete the command response after a certain amount of seconds. After going through these settings, select and command, which will save your changes and add the background check custom command to your Discord server. Now, while on your Discord server, use the command on your own username, for example, and you should see that the command will display the username, icon, join date, roles, permissions, logs, and notes. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.